Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in the previous session, we have seen the single inheritance concept. In this session, we'll go with one more inheritance concept, that is multi-level inheritance concept. So coming to this inheritance concept, we see that, so we are writing two different classes and one class is acquiring the properties of another class. So acquiring the properties means accessing the variables and methods of another class. So here in the single inheritance, there will be a base class, and from the base class, the derived class will be inherited. So derived class. So only one base class and one derived class. So derived class will acquire the properties from this base class. So that means by creating the object for this derived class, through this object it can access the variables and the methods of both base class as well as child class, also constructors. So I think we have covered all these things in the previous session. Just I will post the link in the description section. So if you are having any doubts, you can refer to that single inheritance concept. Now coming to this multi-level inheritance. So multi-level inheritance. So in this multi-level inheritance, so there will be three steps. That is a grandparent. So we call this as parent class and this as child class. But here in this multi-level, there will be a grandparent. A grandparent class, so parent class and a child class, right? So from the grandparent, parent will acquire the properties, and from the parent, child will acquire the properties, right? So this is the base class, this is a derived here as well as base here. And this is a derived class, right? So base to derived and again base to derived. So here, right? Hope you understood this one. Parent will acquire the properties of grandparent. Child will acquire the properties of parent. So parent will be the base class for child. Grandparent will be the base class for parent, right? So here, in the single inheritance, the derived class object is created, and through the derived class object, we can access the variables, methods, constructor of both base and child class. So here, this parent is a derived class as well as a base class. So if you create an object for a parent class, through this object, we can access the constructors, methods, variables of parent as well as grandparent. Through the object of parent class, we can access the constructors, methods, variables of parent as well as a grandparent, because here parent is derived from grandparent class. So from the derived class object, we can access the variables, methods of derived class and a base class. And coming to this child, if you create an object for this child, so we can access constructors, methods, variables of child as well as parent, and parent is again acquiring the properties of grandparent. So also the grandparent, the variables methods of grandparent, right? So if you create an object for this child object can acquire the properties of, that means acquiring the properties means constructors, methods, variables of child class, parent class, and parent is again deriving the properties from grandparent. So child object can also access the variables, methods and constructors of this grandparent. But this parent cannot access the variables and methods of child. Grandparent cannot access the variables, methods, constructors of a parent. Okay, hope you understood. So child can access the derived class object, can access the methods and variables of parent, but not parent can't access the variables and methods of a derived class. Base class cannot, base class object can't access the variables of this derived class object. So this is how, that means in a level wise, grandparent, parent and child. So here grandparent is a base class, parent is both a derived and base class. So child is only the derived class. So hope you understood this one. So here we'll write three classes. So we'll write the three classes, class, some grandparent. You can write the methods and variables, and we can write again parent class, methods and variables, and we can also write the child class. And again here parent inherits the grandparent, so we have to implement the inheritance with the help of colon, and we have to mention this scope resolution, that is this access specifier. So without mentioning this access specifier, it will be treated as a default, it will be treated as a private, so it can't be accessed in other classes. So if it is a public, then it can be accessed in any other class outside the class. So public gparent, and child class is again inherited from public parent, and write down the methods, close. Now we, with the help of this child class object, we can access the methods and variables of parent and grandparent. With the help of parent object, we can access the variables, methods of parent and grandparent, right? So hope you understood this one. So if you are having any doubts, so let us work out with a compiler so that your doubts will be clarified. So we'll execute a small program demonstrating this multi-level inheritance, right? Let's move on to the compiler.
Hi friends, so just now we have seen about the multi-level inheritance in C++. We'll implement the same concept by writing the program. So we'll write the program to implement the multi-level inheritance. First we'll include the IO stream in order to get the input and output statements, and we'll include conio.h for clear screen function. And now we will create one class. So as I said, that the multi-level inheritance means grandparent, parent and child. So we have to write three classes, and among these three classes, two classes to be inherited. So parent class should be inherited from the grandparent, and child class should be inherited from the parent. So class gparent. So just we'll write the constructor. Simply we can write the function. So we have to use the scope access specifier public, right? So we'll declare one function, or we'll simply write the display function. So void display cout grandparent class, right? Right, just one line statement, we'll go with this. So close this class, and we also create one more class called parent, which is inherited from. So in order to implement the inheritance, we have to use the colon operator. So colon, give the scope for the class public gparent, So class parent is inherited from the G parent. Now again, we'll use one more thing, show function cout. Parent class. Right, completed. So close the class, and again we can use child class, which is again inherited from the parent class. Again, you have to write the scope and write down the parent, and again use the scope public void child display. The function is child display. So cout, again I am writing child class, right? So close the class. So we have written three classes only with only one function, just for a demo. So G parent with a function display having a scope public, and again parent class which is inherited from the G parent. So again the public scope, the show method, and again the child class has been created and it is inherited from the parent class, and again in the child class again we are using the scope public, we are creating the child display method, and now we have to write the main function here. So void main, right? So in concept of inheritance, so before the concept of inheritance, if you want to access the methods or the variables of a class, we need to create an object, and through the object we can access the variables and methods. So here every class is having only one method. In order to access that method, we have to create an object for that particular class. If you access this G parent, the method of a G parent, we have to create an object for G parent, and then we have to access that method through the object of G parent. Similarly, parent object should be created for accessing the method written in parent class. Similarly, child object should be created, and through the child object we have to access the method written in child class. But here we are implementing the inheritance concept. So parent is inherited from the grandparent, so we need not create an object for G parent. We can create an object for parent, and we can access the variables and methods of both parent class and G parent class. So the object of derived class can access the variables and methods of derived class as well as the base class. So here parent is the derived class and G parent is the base class. Similarly, child is the derived class, and whereas parent is derived class. So the child object can inherit the properties from parent and grandparent, but a parent class can inherit the properties from grandparent. So in order to access the methods of grandparent and parent, we can create an object for a child, so that child is inherited from the parent, which is again inherited from the grandparent. So child object can access the methods of both the child class, parent class, and grandparent class. Coming to the parent, only child class variables or methods can be implemented. So we'll write the main function. So that you will understand. Okay, I have written the main function, right? So clear screen function. So in order to clear all the previous outputs, so we'll create object for a parent p1. So with the help of p1, we can access the methods p1.show as well as p1.display, so which is written in grandparent class, right? And see, I will explain to you. So we'll save this mlevel.cpp. So let us compile it. Let us run this. Yes, successfully. So parent class, grandparent class. So we are not creating an object for grandparent, but even though this display function is accessed through the parent object, because parent is inherited from the grandparent. So if you want to access the child class with the help of a parent object, it is not possible, because parent is a base class, child is a derived class. So from the parent class object, we can't access the methods of a child class. See, so there is an error called child display is not a member of parent. right? In order to access this parent, I mean this child class, so create one object for child. So just put the comment for object parent object. So through the child object, we can call all the methods of parent and grandparent. So compiled, executed. Now we'll see the output: parent, grandparent, and child class. So child class object is created. So here only one object is created, that is also through a child. So child object can inherit the properties of the base class, that means a parent class. So here the object, the child object can access the methods of child class and a parent class, as well as a parent is again a derived class for base class, grandparent. So child class can also access the methods of a grandparent, right? So similarly, parent can access the methods of grandparent and parent, but not child. And grandparent cannot access the variables and methods of a parent and child, right? So this is how we can implement the multi-level inheritance. Grandparent and a parent and a child. Child acquires the properties of parent, and a parent again acquires the properties of grandparent, right? So hope you understood this. So let us stop here. In the next session, we'll go with the multiple inheritance, right? So if you are having any doubts regarding this inheritance concept, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section, so that I will definitely try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really understood my sessions, like my sessions, share my sessions with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.